Today we are presenting the Mini Theater, having a special guest, and he is a baritone.
Baritone.
And his name is David.
David.
Do you like David, or you prefer David?
The way you like, whatever. Even you can call me another name. Mm. From you, it sounds great anyway.
believe me, people get so crazy in the UK for French accent.
Really?
Hello, David.
Yes, I tried to speak like that.
So tell
but
me.
I can do with the British accent. I can do, oh, this is absolutely brilliant.
No.
I can't.
Believe me, people like us with an accent,
yeah,
we go far.
I should, okay, so yes. I would follow your advice.
So tell me about you.
Yes. Well, my name is David Serero. Mm-hmm. I am an opera singer, a baritone, but I don't sing just opera. Mm-hmm. I sing, I have a large variety of styles. I sing Broadway musicals, I sing jazz standards, I sing Russian music.
I heard you singing
Gypsy
in Russian.
Music and Besame Mucho and Spanish songs. I love to, you
that's
know.
That's my favorite song.
That's your favorite song? Besame, besame mucho.
Oh my God.
Try not to sing too loud because the sound guy will kill me.
No, it's absolutely yeah. perfect. So tell me, what are you doing here in the UK?
Well, you know, London is actually one of my favorite cities. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, I don't come as much as I can in London. But I'm lucky to have an exciting week starting in... you know, to perform.
Yeah.
So we had a very nice documentary that was made about me in London. Uh-huh. We have this concert tonight at the Dominion Theatre, which is a wonderful venue. Uh-huh. I gave a concert charity uh-huh. 2 days ago, and tomorrow another performance at the Cirque du Soir, which is a wonderful nightclub. And, you know, I just love to do that. You know, one night, every different a different venue, another type of audience, another type of repertoire. And even tomorrow afternoon, actually, I'm going to perform. We're going to go to a hospital, and we're going to perform for the children. Because
to the great among us.
Yeah, absolutely. Because
wow.
it's to me, I have the mojo uh-huh. that when people cannot go to the yeah. opera, it's the opera to go to the people.
This is such
know?
A beautiful
so
thing.
And especially, you know, we need to bring music to where, you know, it can heal, it can change mm-hmm. the people. So this mm-hmm. is why, you know, to go to sing to a hospital is, for me, I have as much respect to sing in a hospital mm. than to sing at the Royal Covent Garden House.
Yes, about 2 years ago, mm-hmm. The place that I work as well, the university uh-huh. in the UK,
yeah.
we have a company that we did actually music therapy for kids.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And
that's
we did
a
huge concert yeah. in a wonderful venue near the Parliament House mm. with a classical music.
That's
and
great.
It's everything. Yeah. And do you know how many people get healed just to hear music?
You know, but, you know, I did that I do that very often in Paris, you know, because mm-hmm. I have a partnership with the health department education. And mm-hmm. it's just a lot of fun, you mm-hmm. know, to do so. And
so tell me something. You mm-hmm. do very interesting. You are performing in a club. Mm-hmm. How do you think that young people are taking the perception of opera these days?
Well, it's changing actually thanks to the UK and thanks to America, because they have a way to present opera and classical music a little bit differently than we're used to in Europe. You know, we don't. They do it with an entertaining side that is very interesting. They do it with passion. They do it, you know, modern. You know,
they are mixing. They are fusioning.
Exactly.
They
do absolutely this what they call crossover music, and this is very. It works very well in the UK, actually.
But how you, as an artist, as a baritone?
Baritone.
How do you feel that you have to actually go from the tradition to that, or is absolutely
well?
Fine?
You know what? When you decide a plan in your career, is the best way that nothing happens the way you want it to. So my. You know, my idea is just to follow my instinct. Like when there is a jazz song, exactly. You know, I just recorded a duet with Jermaine Jackson. You know,
really?
The brother of Michael Jackson. We recorded a duet on Autumn Leaves, the French song Les Feuilles Mortes.
That is beautiful.
And you know, I was sure that I was going to start to sing, you know, c'est une chanson, you know, like this. And then I said, this is not.
And then
you started
to sing like Michael Jackson?
No. And then I said, you know what? I just follow my instinct and I just sang it. C'est une chanson qui nous ressemble.
Oh my God.
Tu m'aimais.
I'm a sucker for musicians.
Et nous vivions les deux ensemble.
Right, I'm gonna make it.
Toi tu m'aimais, moi qui t'aimais. You see, it's you follow what the song wants you to go to. So it doesn't matter.
But also the audience gives you the energy.
Absolutely.
It makes you.
And this is why in the UK, you know, like in cities like London, like Paris, like New York, you know, you feel all this. Cosmopolitan, you know, people.
Lots of emotions at the same time.
You see, tonight we have a lot of Russian people. You have a lot of. We have a lot of French. We have some British. I hope
we have some Latins like me. Hello.
Yeah, exactly. We have a little bit of everything, and this is what I love. And actually, my repertoire represents all of that. They are all this type of singers, and I'm lucky to invite also, by the way, another great singer to share the stage. I'm human people. I love to share things and the audience.
New experiences.
And exactly.
So tell me, with all of that, what is next for you? What are you doing next?
Next, I'm doing in Paris a musical by Duke Ellington. Mm-hmm. It's called Beggar's Holiday. It has never been performed.
Right.
I'm going to do it in November in Paris. Then in January, I'm going to be doing a show, sharing the stage with Jermaine Jackson. Uh-huh. We're going
to
be the two together. On the
I want to
two
go
man
there.
Yeah, please be my guest. Two-man musical. Is going to be in January, and basically it's the story of an opera singer and a pop star who meet, you know, so what happens, you know.
It's
so
very interesting.
It's very, very funny, and there is his album, which is called I Wish You Love, that I produced and arranged and did from everything from
A to
Z.
So you produce?
Absolutely, I produce.
You wrote as well? Everything.
Yeah, I produce, I act in films as well, I do produce shows, musicals, you know, I do... All my best.
You're
going to
be the new
exist,
Simon Cowell in Paris, I bet.
Yeah.
Well, we wish you all luck.
Thank you.
Maybe you don't need that.
No. I need to be with your television more often.
We are actually standing. This is going to be 110 nations.
Oh, yes.
And just in London, I got 16,000 people.
Oh, my God. I'm so happy.
And in LA.
Yeah.
As well, so.
Oh, wow. I love LA. Well, actually, I was just there to record the Jermaine Jackson album. So,
we're going to be back soon. Is gonna see you there.
And God bless this great television.
Okay.
You guys are fantastic. Thank you.